environmental impacts of energy use. In the previous two lessons, lesson three, two and three, we were talking about two types of energy sources, that is the renewable and non-renewable energy sources. Both of them in general, the renewable energy sources and non-renewable energy sources, people use them as a source of energy for heating, for producing other types of energy like electrical energy. So our life depends on energy sources, either renewable or non-renewable. But using these resources, using energy sources, can have environmental impacts or environmental effects. So using energy, yes, we need energy. Yes, energy is important, but using energy have many environmental impacts. It affects, using energy affects our nature, affects our environment, okay? And many of these effects are not good. For example, pollution is one of the most problems. Pollution is one of the most problems from using energy, especially the non-renewable energy sources. Example, again, using energy sources, okay, using energy sources can have environmental impacts. Okay, can have environmental impacts or problems. We can say, you can say, instead of the word impact, problems, using energy can cause problems to the environment. Example of these problems, pollution. Okay, what is pollution? Pollution means that there are toxic, there are toxic or poisonous when there are toxic or poisonous substances in air or water or soil. This is called pollution. One of the most important, just an example, one of the most important problems or impacts of using energy is pollution. When there are toxic or poisonous substances in the air, in water, in the soil, this is called pollution. Non-renewable energy sources, non-renewable energy sources are more or can cause pollution and other problems. Okay, so you have to know that if we compare the non-renewable energy sources and renewable energy sources, we can say that the non-renewable energy sources, oil or petroleum, coal, natural gas, burning of these resources can cause pollution and other problems. But in general, the renewable energy sources can cause few problems to the environment. Okay. So we can say that the renewable energy sources can be friendly to the environment. Again, the renewable energy sources such as solar energy, wind energy, water energy, biomass, these energy sources are more friendly to the environment. But the non-renewable energy sources, such as coal, oil, natural gas, can cause many problems to the environment. The most important problem that is pollution, air pollution, water pollution, soil pollution. This is an introduction to the environmental impacts of using energy. Let's start, inshallah. Look at this example. As you pass a modern power plant, you are likely to see tall towers such as those shown in the photograph. Look at this power plant. This is, as you see, a power plant. In this plant or in this factory, we can generate electricity or other types of energy. But what's wrong with this, the power plant? As you pass a modern power plant, you are likely to see tall towers, such as those shown in the photograph. They appear to release smoke, but they are not smokestacks. Look at this. This is, as you see here, this is not smoke. This is not smoke. It's water vapor. It is water vapor, not a smoke. They appear to release smoke, but they are not smokestacks. What you see coming from the towers is water vapor. It is water vapor. We mean by water vapor, water in a form of gas. As you know, there are three states of matter: solid, liquid, and gas. For example, ice is water, but it is in a solid form. Liquid water that we drink is a water in a liquid form. And we are familiar with water when it is liquid. But when water evaporates, or when liquid water evaporates or changes to a gas, we call it water vapor. Water vapor found in the atmosphere, in the air. And the clouds that you see every day are made up of water vapor. Understood? Again, what is water vapor? It's water in a form of gas. There are three states of matter: solid, liquid, and gas. When water is solid, we call it ice. When it is liquid, we drink it, or the water that we drink or we use in our homes, most of water in our homes or on air found as liquid water. When water become a gas, we call it water vapor. Understood? So this is water vapor. This is water vapor. يعني بالعربي اسمه بخار الماء. Okay. As the vapor cools in the air above the towers, it forms what small droplets. When water vapor reaches to the air or to the atmosphere or to the sky, it cools and condenses and form small droplets. You are actually looking at a cloud, and then it forms a cloud, okay, in the sky above the tower. طيب, what's wrong with this? We are talking about environmental impacts of using energy. What is the problem that is caused by this smoke? Power plants make a lot of steam. If you remember that power plants make a lot of steam to run turbines. The steam condenses to make hot water. Now, in the past, the hot water often was dumped into a river or a lake. Okay, wait, Yusuf, wait. In the past, power plants dump or يعني بتكب الwater هذا, the hot water, when بترمي in a river or a lake. طيب, In towers like these, some of the hot water evaporates from the water surface to form water vapor. طيب. Since it takes energy to make water vapor, the remaining water becomes cooler. When it has cooled enough, that water is recycled to make a new steam. Now, look at the question. Look at this question. What would be some effects on the environment of dumping hot water from a power plant into a river? Is this good for the environment? Again, look at the question. What would be some effects on the environment of dumping hot water from a power plant into a river? Is it good for the river? Is it good for the environment to dump hot water from the power plant into a river? Do you think this practice should be allowed? Yani, do you think that this is good? Do you think that we should allow this thing? طيب, I want to see your answers. Can anyone answer this question? Please raise your hands.
Me.
طيب, let's listen to Malak. علي صوتك يا ملاك.
No.
So you think that it's not good for the environment. We should not allow this practice. طيب, why?
Teacher.
Teacher, I know.
طيب. Wait. Listen to Malak. لا, علي صوتك يا ملاك.
Mama.
So we can help our town.
So what?
So we can like محافظ على I can't say it at in by I can't say it at English.
طب okay.
At Arabic.
Okay.
عشان نحافظ على البيئة بعتنا.
طب good, thank you. يوسف.
نحافظ على الحيوانات.
Thank you, Malak. Malak, sorry. تفضل يوسف.
Come on. No, because it turns to water pollution.
Thank you. It can cause water pollution. That's good. Aram.
No, because it makes the air not good and it makes people sick.
Fine. Is there anyone that have can answer or add anything? Do you like to add anything? Muhammad Nasser.
خلاص.
Muhammad,
because it harmful the environment and the fish in the
ممتاز ممتاز شكرا كثير يا محمد. Thank you very much. Excellent. الآن, as you know, in the river there are living things like fish. If you dump hot water, لما بنحط المي بنرمي المي الحامية بالريفر, هذول these living things like fish can't live, may die, because they for example the water, the temperature of river, they live in a specific temperature. يعني هما بيعيشوا بدرجة حرارة معينة من الريفر. إذا حطينا مي حامية راح يصير الريفر إيش hot, وهذا ممكن إيش يأثر على living things such as fish. Thank you very much. So dumping hot water in the river is not good or harmful to the living things that live in the river like fish. Is it clear?
Okay.
طيب okay.
Okay.
Let's continue.
Dump to water
vapor. Okay. Go to the page 86, please. turn or shift to page 86, impact of energy production. طيب. What are the impact or what are the impacts of energy production? To talk about this, we must understand what does the word impact mean? What do we mean by the word impact? Okay, the human use of energy, when we use energy, it has impacts. The word impacts means effects. يعني خلينا نحكي بالعربي الامباكتس معناها بالعربي آثار. شو هي الآثار المترتبة عن استخدام الطاقة؟ هذا هو موضوع الدرس. The human use of energy has impacts or effects. إلو آثار on the environment. Okay, اللي هي البيئة. طيب خلنا نشوف إن شاء الله يعني today and in the coming lessons we are going to talk about these impacts. Most of these impacts are not good, especially for non-renewable energy sources. By the way, in general, non-renewable energy sources cause pollution. They are not friendly to the environment. They are not good to the environment. The non-renewable energy sources, I mean petroleum, coal, natural gas. And on the other hand, the renewable energy sources like solar energy, wind energy, water energy, the biomass, geothermal energy, these resources have a little impact or a few effect, or they can cause a few problems to the environment. Okay, so we should use more and more of renewable energy sources, and we should minimize or stop use the non-renewable energy sources. By the way, many of the environmental problems that we many of the environmental problems are caused by the non-renewable energy sources. Five. These impacts occur when humans change the land to build a structure or remove a resource. For example, the first example, when humans change the land to build a structure or to remove a resource. For example, if humans want to build, to make a new road. Suppose that humans want to make a new road. They should, for example, destroy the land and cut the trees. So this can cause a problem to the environment. طيب. Also, the process of energy production, this process, energy production, when we want to produce energy, it can have environmental problems or environmental impacts. Okay? Now, you should know another important way to understand this, the impacts of energy production. We must understand this word, emissions. What do you mean by emissions? Emissions are the release of what? Of substances into the environment. Type. I will tell you or explain it more. What do you mean by emissions? What does this word mean, emissions? Okay. When we burn coal, when we burn coal to produce electricity or for heating, whatever, this burning, if you remember, burning fossil coal is called combustion. And this process releases or produces what? Some substances such as carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is not good for the environment. It is toxic. It is poisonous. So carbon dioxide is called one of the emissions. When we burn coal, carbon dioxide is released So we call carbon dioxide as emission or emissions. Anything that is released to the environment is called emission, or things that release to the environment called emissions. Okay? Another example of emissions, there are, for example, another toxic substances that are released by burning or using energy or producing energy. All of these are called emissions because they go to the environment. They go to the air, they go to the water, they go to the soil. These emissions, when we have a lot of emissions, they can cause or destroy the environment. So emissions are the release of substances into the environment. Some of these substances are liquid, some of these substances are gas, like carbon dioxide. Some of these substances are solid, like the waste. So the emissions are the release of substances into the environment, are the release of substances into the environment. The process of energy production can release or have many emissions that have impacts on the environment. Some emissions can have a harmful impact or dangerous impact on the environment. Okay, some emissions can have harmful impact on the environment. For example, releasing a pollutant. Pollutant are materials or substances that can cause pollution. Okay, so the word pollution comes from this word, pollutant. Pollutants cause pollution. طيب, example, releasing a pollutant or harmful substance, يعني pollutant اللي هي, أو pollutants هي بالعربي المواد الملوثة. طيب, pollutant or harmful substance during energy production can poison land, water, and air. And if land or water or air become, if these things, land, water, and air are poisoned, so humans and other living things will be affected because we live on land. We use the land, we use the soil, we use water, we breathe air. So these emissions that are released from energy production can cause pollution or releasing pollutant or harmful substances. A pollutant is a harmful substance, and these pollutants can cause or poison land, water, or air. So the water, air, and land become polluted. And that's what we mean by pollution. That's enough for today. Thank you for listening. By the way, this lesson or this class is just an introduction for lesson 4. Inshallah, more details, more explanation will be in the next class. Right. Do you have any comments?
Dad?
What does
I want to ask you questions. طيب. Which is better for the environment? To use renewable resources or non-renewable?
Renewable.
طيب, why? What are the problems? The process of energy production can have impacts on the environment. Can anyone tell me what are these impacts?
What is the question?
What are the impacts of energy production?
Pollution.
طيب والله no one answer without permission. ما حد يجاوب إلا لما يرفع إيده.
جواب.
طيب لانا تفضلي. صوتك مش طالع يا. طيب هادية ممكن تجاوبي؟ هادية تفضلي تقدر تجاوبي؟
What is the question?
طيب.
Can you tell me what are the impacts of energy production? Or are there any impacts of energy production?
Pollutant.
Who says pollutant? That's right. That's right, Muhammad. Thank you. طيب نسمع لعمر. عمر. Can you add anything? What are the impacts of energy production? طيب صوتك مش يوسف. طيب thanks عمر. يوسف.
Water pollution, air pollution, land pollution.
Thank you very much. طيب goodbye for everyone.
Bye.
بكرة عطلة زي ما بتعرفوا إن شاء الله. طيب best wishes و have a nice weekend.
Teacher, tomorrow is Thursday.
Teacher.
بس
tomorrow is Thursday.
I know. بس.
أستاذ.
نعم.
لينا نسمعه.
بكرة عيد ميلاد الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم.
صلى الله عليه وسلم.
What
the screen? Goodbye.
Goodbye.